Hey folks, this is Njobl Ulram-blr and welcome to another episode of Rambling Skyrim. I guess what I'm going to call this series. Anyway, we stopped last time in front of what I believe is the prison that the alternate start mod starts you in. So if you choose to escape this cell, I think you're escaping that one. And good luck with that. Anyway, we're out in the rain and thunder and lightning and wanted to take a peek up there before we left the area. And I think crossing that bridge would probably be the best chance of going over the top, because I don't think I can scale any of these cliff sides here. So we've been through here, so there should be no reason to have to sneak. And I see him reversed here. There we go. That's where I want to be. So that's where the mages had taken over, that little fort there. Nobody out and about at the moment, right? Yeah, we're pretty clear. So we should be safe at least down to the bridge. Chase this goat down here. Anything's going to eat us, we're going to eat a goat first. Okay, goat took a detour. Alright, what's out here? It's quite the river. Interesting. So this river comes in from two directions. Coming in from there and from over there. What's it look like on the map? Ah, okay. So it comes down and drops into there and comes down and drops into there. There I am. Ooh, I got up on the top. Usually I get caught and don't make it on the top of these bridges. What is out here? Anything interesting before we take off? Let's see, there'd be a giant out there somewhere. Probably too far away to see. Probably see some fish jumping in the waterfall there. Alright, let's see if we can get up this thing. That's right. I did a little looking at the Elder Scrolls wiki. And apparently we are on planet Nirn, N-I-R-N. The big moon is Masser, and the small moon is Secunda. Oh, there you are. I seen the moons circling the planet, realizing, hey, this ain't Earth. Or not the Earth that I know of. And so that's the lore behind this. We're actually in a different planet, a different system, different star system. Can I get up this? Let me think about that. Back up a minute. No, maybe over here. Oh wait, I bet you I can get up this one. Ah, there we go. Yeah. That'll do it. Now where? One this general direction. Try this one. There's a top of the tower? Seems like it'd be over there. Or is that a rock? Guess we'll find out. Now, did I ever activate that iron gauntlets? Yeah. Okay. Just trying to remember back last episode what I did or didn't. What I did or didn't did. Can I climb this? He's sure slowing down. Ugh, we're slipping. Come on. Come on. There we go. What is that? That's a bush. So where am I? Sneak does feel a lot slower than I remember. Pretty sure that mod that reasonable speed tweaked the sneak downward. Wish I'd left it alone. So I may have to shut that mod down so I can stay in sneak, but not. What else is out here? What are you? Look like more of these ruins. There's smoke over there. I want to get on that tower. I have a feeling when I go down over the side, I'm not going to be able to get back up. What's the smoke? What are you? Is that a tree trunk or is that something? No, that's just a tree branch. It looks like a wolf sitting there staring at me. What can see me? I don't see it. You guys see it? It's sure active. Well, that was a mess. More? I'm hitting again. Okay, but that one got a good bite out of me. My health bar went down. Two pelts. Okay. So, does that mean this area is clear now? So, they were just hiding down there under that tree. Try and do that in the fog. Good luck. What is over there? I'm curious. You know that saying about curiosity and cats? Go from tree to tree here. Is it a campfire or is it a some kind of a burnt out place? That looks like a pyre. You know, a stack of wood, burn a body on, but that wouldn't explain all the rest of the smoke. Don't see any people around. I don't know what that thing is right there. Can't tell what that is. Oh, giant. This is the giant's area. And there's the giant right there. Quite off in the distance. He's quite small from this distance. Okay. Yeah, we're not going to go play with giants. But now we know. Now this is the other ruin chunk that we saw. Let's go see if there's anything associated with this. Actually, that's quite a shelter right there, isn't it? Yeah. What time is it anyway? We are at midnight. Interesting. I've got the, I don't know if I mentioned, I've got the brightness turned up on purpose so that we can, we don't have to sleep at night in order to be able to see in the video. I wanted to be able to continue on, though in reality you probably should get kind of asleep in here. Gonna be a bad idea. I can see, though it won't quite let me in there. This would be a place to kind of sneak in and tuck in there and hide and grab 6 hours sleep. That probably seems like a reasonable thing to do. I think I'm gonna go for 5 though. Get up before it gets too bright out. And we'll see if some animal comes walking by and rudely awakens me. No, I probably should have slept with my sword out, huh? Anyway, alright, so we've got something to get some sleep, and probably wouldn't hurt to grab some kind of an apple. We'll do a green apple and a red apple. Yeah, there's a balanced diet. Anyway, so there's nothing going on here. Nothing in the tree trunk. Are there any tree trunks in Skyrim that have something hiding in them? Like 7 Days to Die? That's where I got in the habit of always checking tree trunks was that game. Let's head back over here, peek over the top, drop into that tower. Is that our tower? No, that's the other tower that we could see from over there. So this is yet a third place that we saw up here. Okay. So this chunk of tower has nothing in it. We need to get to that one. Ooh, did I pick the wrong place to jump across? I guess I can make this. Okay. There it is. I knew there was a chest up here. I'm playing this one quite some time ago. Oh. Well, there's something we gotta check out next. Interesting. Let's see what that is. Somebody's summer home? Alright, novice. We have one lockpick down there in the bottom right. Novice. Means quite a bit of spread between each position. Let's try straight up. Ooh. Well, we got to start here. Where does the lockpick tap? Whoa. I got lucky twice. That's pretty nice. All right. Petty soul gem, amethyst, and gold. We'll take that and... thank you much. Alright, it's about 6 a.m. Sun's coming up. Now we can see off in the distance so much better. Rain has stopped. That's right. Didn't even notice that. So, where do we go from here? I guess right on down that area there. A fast current. So, some kind of a beach resort summer home here. Last thunderstorm or several thunderstorms ago, a wind came through and knocked that over. Bummer. Now, can I get across this without getting caught in the current? Guess I could try swimming for the log if I had to. Woohoo! Guess I'm going for there. Alright, something like that. So, what is this place? And... of all the places for that tree to drop. Not so lucky, huh? Ooh, someone's in there. Lucky Lorenz. Okay. That's quite ironic. Yeah. How do we... let's see if we can go up under this. Cannot. Gotta go around? Or over? Let's walk along the tree trunk. Maybe. Out of sneak mode. That'll do it. Yeah, that worked. Alright, so... lucky. You've got arrows. Got a lockpick, good. Tomatoes, some gold. A treasure map. Ooh. We have in the way weapons. Just a dagger. That's me. So you... we can't categorize it. Okay, they're all together. Hide armor. Longbow. Ooh. And a treasure map. Okay. Let's grab all of that. And let's take a look at some things. Weapons. Longbow. Great. Finally have a bow. So you, favorite... and still sword is favorited. Okay, so I've got 8 arrows. Not many. It's kind of like surviving with one lockpick. And then, what did I see? Oh, the books. The treasure map. Up a waterfall, looking at a bridge that goes to Riften. Interesting. Well, we'll do some snooping around here, see if we can figure out which one that is. There's, I think, three bridges in this area. I don't think I have hit this treasure map before. I don't think so. I've done the one above White Run and one somewhere else, but I don't remember that particular picture before. Okay, so that's done. Miscellaneous. Gotta be careful not to click on this side of it. That takes us all away. Two lockpicks now. Don't have any torches yet. Alright, potions. There you are. Do have the two. Apparel? Nothing better, right? So the iron gauntlets, hide bracers. He had hide something. Hide armor. 22. And I have got iron armor 27. This weighs much less. But 5 armor points is significant. Significant enough. Normally I would, if they were, you know, within 1 or 2 of each other, I would sell off the one that weighs 30 and just use the one that weighs 5, so I've got more room in my carry weight later. But I think that's significant enough. I'll hang on to it or continue wearing it. Anyway, all right, let's get out of this and see what else is around here. That one is... I think we're leaving that one behind. This is a family-rated show. All right, you're just a bowl. And that one, you are... Rizlav the Righteous. Light armor increased. Oh, good. All right. Grab it to take. We'll sell that. Okay, you are troll fat. Good. That one over there. Glow dust. Okay, that sells for quite a bit. What's in the barrel? Canis root. Okay, or canis root? I guess it'd be canis. Okay. So we're done. Actually, we have a Shrine of Debella. I don't know what it gives you as far as a perk, but I will check to see if we have contracted any kind of a disease. No. We had rock joint or something that you caught from a... I don't know if wolves will give it to you or not, but the... the big rats, whatever they're called, they'll give it to you. Maybe something else it does to you. But we are disease-free right now, so we'll just ignore that. Anyway, Q Bow, you are my new number 4. So I usually do 1 and 2 for melee, 3 and 4 for bows, and then move on from there. That way, occasionally I'll find myself needing 2 bows. One of them that has some kind of a, what is it called, when you grab someone's soul to load up a soul gem to power weapons that are enchanted. That's about as far into magic as I get in the game. If there's a weapon already enchanted, I'm not gonna not use it. It's, you know, it's someone else's work. Hello? What took you out? You have got some gold in you. Interesting. And the goat over there. We need a bridge that points to Riften. I'm trying to remember where I'm at. That's Whiterun that way, right? Going that way, that's Whiterun. We need one that goes down. That's that bridge right there, and that's the big waterfall. That's where the treasure map's for. Okay, let's go back there. Let's go see what that was about. Now, where here have we already been? That I don't need to run the sneak mode. I think we have been here. Yeah, we went that way toward the jail. The end of last episode. Riften this way. So where is... I'm kind of lost here. Where is that big keep that has the mages in them? In it? Well, I'll just go for a while. Not sure which road I have been on. That's the one that goes to the cave? You get so turned around in here. And yeah, I've been... That's what I'm thinking of. Okay. And so we saw it from the other side where it looked so much closer. There's a mage right there. And I have a feeling if I were to take my new handy-dandy longbow, which isn't very powerful, and send an arrow over there, five of them will pour out of that door right there. You'll just see me squealing like a little girl running up the side of the hill. Probably not the best thing to record, so I'm going to just let them pass. Yeah, we don't need to... Hello? He's purring. Yeah, there's the cave. Let's go discover the cave on the way, though. And then we'll get back to the waterfall, probably the other side of that rock. Anything out here going to discover me? Do have to keep that in mind, too. Looks pretty clear. Pretty gruesome in there. They're obviously sending a message. Come in here. This is what will happen to you. So what are these actually called? Burnt corpses? Not going to tell me, huh? Not going to tell me. Okay, can't interact with them. Alright, let's get out of here. Though it is the start of a nice warm day. Wonder if there's anything under the water. Every once in a while you find a chest or something underneath the water. You do find fish. Get down low enough to see the fish. There's eggs of some kind. Slaughterfish eggs. Ooh, are there slaughterfish in here? That's interesting. Slaughterfish will attack you, at least in Oblivion. But I've never actually seen them in this, in Skyrim. I know you, you can't stay in under here indefinitely. All right. Who's out wandering and walking and ready to yell at me if I get too close? Seems like we went this way last time. Just the other direction. If I stay in sneak mode while there are people out and about near this place, we should get another boost to our sneak skills, which might send us into level 2. We're getting close to that. Okay, well, nobody's out and about. They're all inside their keep. There's a bridge. And I bet you there's a sign over on that side that points to Riften. Like this will as well, right? There's Riften. It showed it being second level. Ah! There it is. Okay. Alright, well, let's take another look. Books. Treasure map. Okay, well, we're seeing... Am I seeing 3 segments instead of 2? So, not above the section we're looking at, but above one more. Above that. And Riften's aiming that way. That feels the opposite, doesn't it? It does. This is not the right bridge? Right waterfall? Huh. Well, if there are 3 segments of this waterfall, if we go up there, then we'll notice it may be the right one. And somewhere at the top of that other one. So. Yeah, there's another one right there. So it's behind that one. Although Riften, the sign's over there, but it aims that way. Well, maybe we can just assume that bandits ain't too smart. They got it backwards. I'm guessing we go up that road, we can sneak back around, switch back. Let's go find out. Now we've been through here. Oh, there's the 2 wolves that mysteriously died. Probably from one of those mages or conjurers or warlocks, or whatever they like to call themselves. You are iron, so we should be fine at least up until about here. Seems like this is where we joined this road. Now I'm trying to get up there. Rabbit's running that way, hopefully from us. Alright, so I think I'm going this way. Though the arrow showed going the other way, maybe because this is pretty hard to traverse. There we go, let's go. Catch this little incline here, okay. So, go up as strong a diagonal as the game will let me. Keep pressing the jump button. Now... okay, we'll switch back up here a little further. Whoa, jump kind of doesn't help there. Alright, now can I get up further? I may have to find another route. And we'll see if this is enough. Usually when you see a transition like right here, it tends to let you start climbing again. There we go. So on a flat plane, if you can't go up, you can't go up. But if you hit a transition in the landscape, it tends to break that a bit. Okay. I'm thinking that's our waterfall, our second one. Let's go find out. I think I want to go as high as I can. Nothing up there. Be easier to drop downhill rather than to try to get uphill afterward. That's not going to help. We got to be coming in up there, I'm going to guess. Alright, so that drops. I think there's where we need to be. I think I can walk back up here well enough, though. Let's go verify that there's nothing right here. I'm thinking it's the top of the second group. There's a rabbit that's stuck in there. It should be right up there. No problem, right? I might be able to go up that way. I think this way is probably a little smarter. We'll find out. Let's take us off of sneak so we can get a little distance, but that grade looks a little bit steep for us. Darn. Just keep shuffling back and forth here. I'm stuck. Jump first. There we go. Alright. What's gonna let me climb? Nope. Alright, so if this isn't going to let us... well, here we go. Okay, I hit a transition. Should be another one right here? Definitely right here. So close! It's right there! Come on, map, let me up here. There we go. Next transition. Try it again. By the tree. There. Call this the Skyrim Shuffle. Hey, there we go. Alright, anything alive up here? Oh, this is a road? Yeah. Just follow the road, Njobl. Or is it Njobl? Njobl Ulram-blr? Is that how you pronounce what I called myself? Feeling very Nordic. Like here I am, the mighty Nord collecting wildflowers. Alright, what's up here? Great place for grizzlies, huh? Alright. One, two, it kind of indicated it was right here. How do I get down there? Well, I know how to get down there, but how do you live getting down there? And what if it turns out it's up here? Okay, check the map again. Books. Treasure map, number 9. I wish I could use my mouse here. Okay, so 1, 2, there is a third one at the very top. This is the middle one right here. It should be in this pool, or alongside of it, or something like that. One more. That would be the top one, that would be the source. If I jump, I'm going to hit that rock, aren't I? I know when Night Ghost plays this, one of his calling cards is whenever he sees a waterfall, he wants to jump into it. That's a swift little current right there. All right, we're going to do a Night Ghost here. Here we go. I'm going to die. Ugh, made it. Now to get out of this current. All right. Is there anything here? If I stay in the middle, maybe I won't get washed away. It's pretty swift. Let's get up in here, maybe let me walk. Okay, where am I going? I don't know. Is there any place behind? There's not. Did we do this for nothing? Something up the hill there, maybe. I don't think I can climb that. Maybe I can jump from rock to rock. It did indicate to come up that side. Okay. Well, let's... Now, there's no secret button or anything like that, right? No. Nothing down under. Okay. Nothing behind the bushes. Right off to the side over here. No. I did not just get stuck there, right? There we go. Okay, well, let's just work our way back and forth up this slope here. Something's going to let me go up. No. Yeah. Ah. Got a leg up on that one. There we go. Kind of. Uh-huh. Keep going, keep going. Get the momentum going. Don't stop, don't stop. Whew. All right. I have a feeling I'm going to spend 15 minutes on this accomplishing nothing. Is there another waterfall in the area? I expect to see a little room right here. Right over the top of this. Slip. Nothing. Alright, one. Oops, I'm a slipping. There we go. One last peek, and we're going to have to call this one done. Books. Treasure map, number 9. It looks like it's slightly above. Within the fall of the third level. If this is it. Now again, Riften's pointing in the wrong direction. So let's think about that. Where would we have to be? We'd have to be at a waterfall on the east, so that Riften is south. Meaning... this road here Riften's there. Now there's a waterfall over here, bridge here, and the sign aiming that way. I don't know where that would be. There's no waterfall over here that I'm aware of. Okay, we're playing in this area with what I assume is this waterfall. This whole thing must be... That's odd that it's got us there. I would have thought we'd be like right up there. Huh. A waterfall down this side with a bridge across here would satisfy it. I'm thinking we're at the wrong waterfall or wrong bridge. We'll just have to kind of keep that in mind as we're traveling around. But I don't think we've got anything that's going to work here. I'm going to die down there, aren't I? I know I am. Okay, let's hop off of this. So what is the plan now? We've got kind of a bow. You're nothing, right? Yeah. I'm kind of an arrow. You know, iron arrows are pretty weak. A bow is only a weapons. 6 damage. And 8 damage. We're doing 14. The sword is 9. So not... We're still pretty wimpy. Let's put it that way. So we're not taking that forward. Do we head off into here? Where it's fairly calm. Fairly safe. Enough to do some leveling up. Take out some bandit camps and that sort of thing. That's kind of what I'm imagining. I've got enough to sell a few things to go into here and get a better bow. But until we get some leveling, they're only going to offer us a hunting bow anyway. And to get a bow that's got an enchantment that'll give you an extra 10 or 15, that's going to take, I don't know, 500 or 600, maybe 1,000 gold, and we don't have anything close to that. But anywhere we go right now, we're going to be overwhelmed. Let's... Uttering Hills Cave. That's the one we got from Darkwater Crossing. Okay. Let's take this road through here and get off to Whiterun. And then maybe hit that bandit camp that's kind of right down over here. And there's another one across the valley. And I think there's a couple of them in there. That should skill us up pretty quickly. We'll go over and take a look at the giant who's over here and... You know, take a selfie. And alright, let's get out of here. Let's find a way to get down this thing without breaking a leg. Ooh, that was a bit of a drop. Now, there's no other spot up in here that I just missed, right? You know, come around behind a tree and there it is. This is the waterfall we can see from up there. So we climbed up to that one. Let's kind of verify that it's not, you know, in a place like this. Well, that'd be a great place for it, huh? I could spend the night in here. Nothing would get you. I remember this spot. It'd be a good place to sneak a catnap. I don't see anything else. Oh! Come on, let me in there. So I can't get into... Whoa, I'm in the current. No, 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 no. Wow, that takes you fast. All right. Treasure map number 9. Nope, not going to happen. All right, off to Whiterun. Now, there is a road that will take us down there. That's where right now? Somewhere off in this direction. Not really a road, more of a path. Which we're not going to find. So, there it is. Mr. Rabbit. Alright, so let's get back to where we were at the other bridge. And keep our eye open for other waterfalls. We're heading north right now. It'd have to be a waterfall on that side, so the sign can be pointing south. So this isn't the right place if the map is correct. Riften is not pointing that direction on the map. Otherwise, it qualifies perfectly. Three levels. Boy, that was disappointing. All right, sneak mode. Let's see if we can gain a point and sneak going past this place. Don't see anybody out and about, though they do wander. Detected. They do wander. Detected from where? Are you out in this area already? Actually, no, this is a sword area. Detected big time. Where? There's nobody at the top there. Oh. Okay, that's a necromancer. Got it. And let's take advantage of that right now. Though you could kind of save it when you level up. You refresh all of these. So a little bit of a cheat is if you're near dying and you're out of health potions, then you could use your level up that you've been saving to kind of get yourself out of that mess. Not really needing stamina much right now. Let's continue to work on the health. We're not taking out camps right now trying to carry everything back. And hopefully when we get the bags from the Bandolier mod, that will offset the need for doing that. Though stamina does do other things as well. I'm going to... We've already done one in sneak. And we need... Well, we can get our second one in sneak. Though we've got archery now. We've got a bow now. So let's go ahead and grab one of those. Overdraw. 20% more damage. Okay. Now, does it reflect that immediately? Items, bow, where are weapons. Does that... That's 6 went to an 8. Okay. So now we're doing 16 damage. Great. She's warning me. I heard her. I don't see her. Where is she warning me from? Right over there. She's sneaking. She's not a red dot. Is she warning somebody else? Okay. I guess she was warning me, and now she's turned around again. Or there are two things happening coincidentally. Aha. Right there. This might be kind of interesting. Let's sit back and watch the show. Who are they? Can't wait till I get further into archery and get the one that lets me zoom in. I can pull the bow and zoom in on them. Are they the ones from, I want to say, Hammerfell? Yeah, they got the big curved sword. The ones that are looking for the, the one who is working in the tavern there in Whiterun. It's hiding in there. Let's see what happens here. We might be able to get a loot of body. Though, if the mage kills these guys, does that quest go away? Or are they unkillable until the quest happens? Curious. But they stopped. Nope, they continued. We're just kind of lurking here. We're trolling them. The mage went where? I don't see her anymore. Her circuit must have curved her back in to there. And they're curving into there too. Just to make sure something happens, huh? That's not a real road. Why would they go that way? That is a side path. Okay, and there's the mages. And they're on high alert. And these guys don't even act like they give a rip. Okay. Well, fine. I'll act that way, too. Huh. Don't hear ya. Just talk to the hand. Alrighty, let's get going. There's at least two in there. I'm sure there's several more. Well, we head down this way for a while. We get into unfamiliar territory. We've seen this from a distance. Hello. You are what? Well, you're not coming at me. No, you're not. So I want to know what you want. Or what you're about. Argonian. Yeah, if I click, I'm committed.
Greetings, brother. You look weary. I have something to help you relax, if you're interested.
Oh, you do, huh? What are you talking about?
The finest skooma, the sweetest moon sugar, at a fair price, of course.
That's what I thought. Now, if I say this doesn't seem legal, he's going to assume that I'm about to turn him in, and he'll attack me. I might be able to take him, or this might be the last episode of this series. I think I'd rather level up a little bit more before I start diving into these side quests, so I'm gonna say no thanks.
Each has their own way.
Uh-huh. And move on. Just don't like the idea of a two-episode series. Now, you're detecting me there. Now, what took this guy out? It would have to be a wolf. There's no reason for a person walking by to do it. Well, there are some bandits that will take him out like they're hunting. The hunters will drop him and just leave him behind. Although they did. I don't know to what extent Immersive Citizen corrects those sort of things. That's possible. Alright, so I believe we're in new territory. And we are going to Whiterun, right? Yes. Okay. We got a big bend of a river coming up here. Let's see what's out there. Otherwise, where do I want to be? I can't really get up on the rocks here. Now, I requeued the bow, right? Yeah. Only 8 arrows. That's a bummer. Let's go up here a little bit and look out over the river. Anything interesting out there? Wolf, right? I think so. He's taking a bath. Otherwise, it looks pretty calm. I do need the pelts. I would like to make as many pouches and bags as I can. I'm not going to waste the arrow, though. Sure. Come on, try and get me. Ew. Whoa, you are amazing. Okay. You are Super Wolf. Man, the speed. Can I still be seen? How can I still be seen? Is he triggered? And coming at me? He may be. But I bet she's stuck over there. Okay. Yeah, the little eyeball's going away. That eyeball, I kind of think of that as my sixth sense. The hairs that stand up on the back of your neck when you just know something's looking at you. Something is out there. So that's what I think of when I do that. Our sneak is up. I notice my game's getting real laggy all of a sudden. Alright, took you out. and I may have to cut this episode short. For some reason, my computer, at about an hour into a game, always seems to start to lag. I don't know if that is an overheating graphics card or an overheating chip, the Intel chip. Could be the processor. I know these are pretty processor heavy, a lot of these games. I wonder if I need to reseat the cooler on that. That's causing it. Any thoughts on that? You might pop them in the comments if you've had something like this happen before yourself. But yeah, this is getting pretty unplayable. So we've got a pretty safe area here. Big bend of the river. We're going up that hill. Waterfall. Don't think it's the same one, though. But let's call this done right here. And there I am. That is me, Njobl Ulram-blr. And I will catch you next time, folks. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.